scriptural link the reception of the level of the received to our sacred space. So to see how far, how many hops you need to get to the base station where you can collect the data, we are showing here the hop count as well. So the top ones here, they are almost all one hop away from the base station, which is here. When you're getting down into the stack of the numbers, you're having sometimes up to four hops. Okay, and that was the highest transmission power that was that's available. Here you can see why we are doing measurements at so many locations, for example, because there's quite a variation inside such a container of the temperature. So you can see up here there's something like 90 degrees, while somewhere in the middle we have 60, or this one's at the top as well. So that all depends also on where the cooling unit is, where the air stream is flowing. Important for the quality is also the humidity. We have the relative humidity from about 60% to 70-85%. So, and because we couldn't always do tests in this unprepared facility to load the containers onto the numbers that take quite a lot of time, we tried to derive propagation more specifically for bananas and see whether we can then use those propagation models in simulations later on. And what you can see here is that those lines are, so those are the measurements here from the airspace propagation, are at lower transmission power. The red one is the highest available transmission power, 1 milliwatt. The sort of nicely curved ones are not normal fittings for this curves. So those dotted lines are for in space propagation. And here those solid lines are the measurements that we have for bananas, and those are here the dashed lines are for measurements for water bottle as you can, water bottles as you can buy them in Germany in the standard process. So this is rather easy to handle, and so we can do with this modeling, we can do then we can have a specific model for propagation in simulations, but we can also, as we can see here, they are rather close to how water behaves, or water bottles behave, so we can also do testing with water bottles which don't go bad as bananas are doing. Okay, so there, this is the concept for the, this is the stuff how to communicate inside the container. However, for a nice supervision system, we need to get the data away from the ship. And there are now two concepts for the data transmission. So one is like the wireless mesh network, where you have all the units in the same gale and communicate to each other, and then with the skin on top, they're transmitting the next gale. That's one concept. So, and another concept is that if you're wiring, you have a base station in every second field, and then that's probably the more even solution there. Those units here, we've built ourselves. This is what we call a communication service module, which is embedded in C, which autonomously selects a network, whether it's wireless LAN or whether it's UPS one on ship, but on a truck, including through Europe. And on the ship, we can use for our test in January from Costa Rica to Europe. We will install the wireless LAN. is how Prisca is presented currently. We are getting some data already from the telematics unit. Additionally, we have now also integrated the data from the wireless sensor network to be displayed there. And from this data, you can, according to biological lightning models, can derive the quality of the food. And with this company that is dealing with logistics processes, can that tell how to distribute this dynamically? Okay, so this is just one small example for how IT or information communication technology can help in reading logistics and so service and communication, so sensitive communication service help so that it's economically viable, usable for the company. It's really a benefit for them because if such a container will fully load it, this is really quite some money that is wasted. Additionally, ecologically, this is interesting because then you can, because you have a better overview of such a container, you can better control the cooling unit. And this cooling unit is quite amounts to 20% of the diesel that is used by transporting it from Central America to Europe. And we've shown that when you have a fully loaded container there, multiple communications may be necessary to communicate in there. We've derived some specific radio propagation model for a fully loaded container. And that's all I have to say for this. I would like to answer your questions.
Is your model of the container facility robust enough that you can look at apples versus bananas versus other sorts of material? In other words, can you put the geometry in with that permittivity, the functional frequency, for the magnetic permeability to have ferromagnetic containers, parts of containers? And that way you could perhaps have some insight that you don't have now.
We don't have to do this for this container. Right. Those containers are only loaded with one sort of wood. For us, it's easier. But however, you can, like, as we have some interface to RFID readers, and you can only move pellets in very specific positions into this container, you can derive when this is moved in, that you know the location at which the sensor nodes are then residing at which point they're located.